Hi dear students, we are entering into the another important idea in the vectors, that is product of vectors. The first one we are going to discuss about scalar product, and then we are going to discuss about vector product. So let's have a discussion here. Before going to discuss about the product of two vectors, what is the angle between two vectors? Angle between two vectors is the angle between two directions. Angle between two vectors is the angle between these two directions, where these two directions converge, or where these two directions diverge, where these two directions diverge from their point of intersection. This is called the angle between two vectors, right? Angle between two vectors is the angle between two directions, where these two directions are converging, or where these two directions are diverging. That is the angle between two vectors. So angle between two vectors is always lies between 0 degrees and 180 degrees. Now you can say in this case, the angle between the vectors, you know, this is one vector, we can say it is a BC bar, and this is another vector, we can say this one as a CA bar. So from this point of intersection, one is moving in this direction, the other one is moving in this direction. From this point of intersection, they are diverging each other. That's why this is called the angle between two vectors. Similarly, this is also the angle between two vectors, right? So at the same point of intersection, they are converging. Okay, so like that, meaning of the angle between two vectors. Now come back to the definition of dot product. A bar comma B bar are two non-zero vectors inclined at an angle theta. A bar, B bar are two non-zero vectors inclined at an angle theta, then scalar product, that is a dot product, is denoted by A bar dot B bar, that is equals to mod A bar into mod B bar into cos theta. So from this we can write cos theta is equals to A bar dot B bar divided by magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar. With the help of this, we can find out the angle between two vectors. At the same time here, A bar dot B bar greater than 0, then we can say theta belongs to closed interval 0 comma pi by 2. That means theta is an acute angle. If A bar dot B bar is less than 0, A bar dot B bar less than 0, then theta belongs to pi by 2 to pi. But what happens? What happens if A bar dot B bar is equals to 0? A bar dot B bar is equals to 0 means dot product is equal to 0 means these are the possibilities. The first possibility is either A bar may be a 0 vector, or B bar may be a 0 vector, or the other possibility is also there, A bar is perpendicular to B bar. So two vectors dot product is equal to 0 means either A bar is a 0 vector, or B bar is a 0 vector, or those two vectors are perpendicular. Let's see here, as we discussed the definition of dot product as A bar dot B bar is equals to mod A bar into mod B bar into cos theta. Now can you tell me what happens to A bar dot B bar? Yes, A bar dot B bar, angle between two vectors, angle between two same vectors, definitely 0 degrees. Cos 0 is equals to 1, that's why we will get magnitude of A bar whole square. So that's why we can write I cap dot I cap is equals to J cap dot J cap is equals to K cap dot K cap must be equals to 1. I dot I, J dot J, K dot K is equals to 1. At the same time, I dot J is equals to I dot K must be equal to 0, because I cap is a unit vector along x axis. This is a unit vector along y axis. Angle between them is 90 degrees. Theta is equal to 90. That's why I dot J you will get 0. I dot K also 0. Similarly, you can say J dot K also you will get 0. J dot. Right? So now, based on this information, what we are going to discuss is one vector A bar is equals to A1I plus A2J plus A3K and other vector V bar is equals to B1I plus B2J plus B3K. Then the dot product of those two vectors is given by A bar dot B bar is equals to I dot I becomes 1, that's why A1B1, I dot J 0, I dot K 0, next J dot I also 0, J dot J becomes 1, J dot K 0, K dot I 0, K dot J 0, K dot K again 1. That's why A bar dot B bar you will get A1 B1 plus A2 B2 plus A3 B3. So that is the way of finding A bar dot B bar. Okay. So let's have what is the geometrical meaning of dot product. Before going to discuss about the geometrical meaning of dot product, this is the one more point. A bar dot B bar is the same as B bar dot A bar. A bar dot B bar and B bar dot A bar both are same. Just observe here, this is one vector, that is A bar, and here we have another vector, that is say B bar. This point is A and this point is B. Now what I am doing is, from this point B, a line is drawn perpendicularly onto the vector OA bar. Let us say that is equals to M. Now angle between these two vectors is equals to theta. Now tell me, from this diagram, what we can write cos theta is equals to? We can write cos theta is equals to OM divided by OB. So that's why I can write OM is equals to OB is nothing but magnitude of B bar into cos theta. Magnitude of B bar into cos theta. That's why I can write A bar dot B bar definition is mod A bar into mod B bar into cos theta. That is the definition of A bar dot B bar. Now in place of mod B bar cos theta, we can write OM. Now from this I can write OM is equals to A bar dot B bar divided by magnitude of A bar. So what is OM? OM is nothing but the projection of B bar on A bar. This length OM is nothing but projection of B bar on A bar. On A bar. That's why denominator we got magnitude of A bar. So this is nothing but projection of, that is geometrical meaning of dot product. Projection of B bar on A bar is given by their dot product divided by magnitude of A bar. Similarly, projection of A bar on B bar is equals to A bar dot B bar divided by magnitude of B bar. That is the geometrical meaning of dot product of two vectors. Here L, comma M are scalars. L, comma M are scalars. Then I can write L A bar dot M B bar is equals to L M into A bar dot B bar we can write, or we can also write it as A bar dot L M into B bar also we can write. At the same time, A bar dot minus B bar we can also write it as minus A bar dot B bar. Okay, so now here, what is the vector component of A bar along B bar? Vector component of A bar perpendicular to B bar. So this is the discussion, another one we are going to do. This is the vector A bar, and here we have another vector B bar. Right? So A bar and B bar are two vectors here. Now what I am going to do is projection of B bar on A bar. That's what we will call it as vector component of B bar along A bar. Or we can say the same as orthogonal projection of B bar along A bar. Vector component of B bar along A bar. That we can also say it as orthogonal projection of B bar along A bar. So how to find out that one? Now from this point a line is drawn perpendicularly onto this. Let us say this one as O and this is equals to A and this particular point is B and we can say this one as M. Now we require to find the vector OM bar. You know the vector OM bar how to find out. OM bar is equals to, how to get OM bar? OM bar is equals to the length OM is multiplied with a unit vector in the direction. But what is OM? OM is nothing but projection of B bar on A bar. So that's why B bar dot A bar, or we can say A bar dot B bar by magnitude of A bar into A cap. That is the orthogonal projection of B bar along A bar. Orthogonal projection of B bar along A bar is given by A bar dot B bar by mod A bar into A cap. This length is multiplied with a unit vector in the direction. We required OM bar. That OM bar only orthogonal projection of B bar along A bar. Next, what he is asking? Orthogonal projection of B bar perpendicular to A bar. That means we required this one. Yes, we can find out easily. We required the vector MB bar, right? Just now we know OM bar plus MB bar must be equal to OB bar according to the triangle law of addition of vectors. OM bar plus MB bar is equal to OB bar. Now we required MB bar. So we can write MB bar is equals to, what is OB bar? OB bar is equals to B bar minus OM bar, just now we got, that is A bar dot B bar divided by magnitude of A bar into A cap. Right? So this is the orthogonal projection of B bar along A bar, whereas this is the orthogonal projection of A bar perpendicular to, orthogonal projection of B bar perpendicular to A bar, right? So just now we discussed A bar dot A bar is always equals to mod A bar whole square, right? So I can write A bar plus B bar mod A bar plus B bar whole square. We can write it as A bar plus B bar dot A bar plus B bar. Now this simplification we can write it as A bar dot A bar is mod A bar whole square. Next one is mod B bar whole square. The next one is plus 2 times A bar dot B bar. That is mod A bar plus B bar whole square. A bar dot B bar. In the similar way, mod A bar minus B bar whole square we can write it as A bar minus B bar dot A bar minus B bar. The same we can also write it as mod A bar whole square plus mod B bar whole square minus 2 times A bar dot B bar. Now if you add these two, what happens? Mod A bar plus B bar whole square plus mod A bar minus B bar whole square is equals to, these two addition, this one cancel, you will get 2 times mod A bar whole square plus mod B bar whole square. Now if you subtract these two, what happens? Mod A bar plus B bar whole square minus mod A bar minus B bar whole square is equals to 4 times A bar dot B bar we will get. At the same time, A bar plus B bar dot A bar minus B bar, what we can write? A bar plus B bar dot A bar minus B bar, we can write mod A bar whole square minus mod b bar whole square. But what we can write now, a bar plus b bar plus c bar whole square, mod a bar plus mod b bar plus mod c bar whole square can be written as mod a bar whole square plus mod b bar whole square plus mod c bar whole square plus 2 times a bar dot b bar plus b bar dot c bar plus c bar dot a bar, that is mod a bar plus mod b bar plus c bar whole square we can write. Now here magnitude of a bar plus b bar is always less than or equals to mod a bar plus mod b bar. Actually no need to prove this one especially. The reason is it is a triangular inequality. Yes or no? It's a triangular inequality. Sum of the two sides is always greater than the third side. Sum of the two sides is always greater than the third side. Otherwise, if you want to prove this one by using this dot product, how to prove? Observe here. We know that cos theta is always less than or equals to 1. Now multiply both sides with 2 times magnitude of a bar into magnitude of b bar into cos theta is less than or equals to 2 times mod a bar into mod b bar. I hope so everyone followed. Now add both sides, mod a bar whole square. Here mod a bar whole square, here mod b bar whole square added. So this side also add mod a bar whole square plus mod b bar whole square. Now what we can write this one as? This can be written as a bar plus b bar magnitude whole square is less than or equals to mod a bar plus mod b bar whole square. Now if you remove, you will get magnitude of a bar plus b bar is less than or equals to mod a bar plus mod b bar, that is the triangular inequality. At the same time, a bar dot b bar is less than or equals to mod a bar whole square into mod b bar whole square, that is called Cauchy's Schwarz inequality, which is called Cauchy's Schwarz inequality. Here also the same thing we can write. We know that cos square theta is less than or equals to 1. Now both sides multiply with 2 times mod a whole square, right, mod a whole square mod b whole square into cos square theta is less than or equals to mod a bar whole square into mod b bar whole square. Both sides we multiplied with mod a bar whole square and mod b bar whole square. Now what we can write this one as? That is nothing but a bar dot b bar whole square is less than or equals to mod a bar whole square into mod b bar whole square, that is the Cauchy's Schwarz inequality. So these are the few ideas related to the dot product. So based on these ideas, just I want to discuss a few questions. The first question is like this: for any vector r bar is equals to r bar dot I cap into I cap plus r bar dot j cap into j cap plus r bar dot k cap into k cap. For any vector r bar dot I cap into I cap, r bar dot j cap plus r bar dot k cap is equals to r bar, that I want to show. Here, one thing we have to keep it in mind, I, j, k are unit vectors. At the same time, I, j, k are unit vectors, that means they are of equal magnitude. At the same time, they are mutually perpendicular vectors. So that's the reason. What I am doing here is, I am taking r bar is equals to a into I plus b into j plus c into k. I am taking the vector r bar as. Now tell me what is r bar dot I. This is a dot producted with I. You will get a. Because k dot I 0, j dot I 0, I dot I is 1. R bar dot I, you will get a. So from this I can write r bar dot I cap into I cap, r bar dot I cap into, here I am not writing any dot or cross, r bar dot I cap into regular multiplication into I cap is equals to, you will get A into I cap. In the similar way, what about r bar dot j cap into j cap? Yes, you will get b j cap. Next, r bar dot k cap into k cap, definitely you will get c into k cap. If you add all these, you will get this one. That is nothing but r bar r naught. So that's why I, j, k are, we know, mutually perpendicular vectors at the same time, unit vector, that means of equal magnitude. Then r bar dot I into I cap plus r bar dot j into j cap plus r bar dot k into k cap is equals to r bar. That's why here another result we can derive, we can discuss from there. A bar, b bar, c bar are mutually perpendicular vectors of equal magnitude lambda. These three vectors are mutually perpendicular vectors of equal magnitude lambda. Then we can write r bar dot a bar into a bar plus r bar dot b bar into b bar plus r bar dot c bar into c bar must be equals to lambda square into r bar. Because here I am saying A bar, B bar, C bar are mutually perpendicular vectors of equal magnitude. That magnitude is given by lambda. That's why lambda square into R bar we will get. So this is the another question. A cap, B cap. That means these two are unit vectors inclined at an angle theta. Right? Then he is asking, what about magnitude of A cap minus B cap? And what about magnitude of A cap plus B cap? So he is asking magnitude of A cap minus B cap. Now I am finding magnitude of A cap minus B cap whole square I am finding. So that we can write it as magnitude of A cap whole square plus magnitude of B cap whole square minus 2 times magnitude of A cap into magnitude of B cap into cos theta. Mod A bar minus B bar whole square is equal to mod A bar whole square plus mod B bar whole square minus 2 times A bar dot B bar. A bar dot B bar means mod B bar cos theta. These are unit vectors. Unit vector means magnitude is equals to 1. So what we will get? That is equals to 2 minus 2 times cos theta. So that is equals to 2 into 1 minus cos theta can be written as 2 sin square theta by 2. Yes, that's why we can write magnitude of A cap minus B cap is equals to 2 times sin theta by 2. Right? Are magnitude of A cap minus B cap only he is asking. That is equals to 2 times sin theta by 2. But he is asking magnitude of A cap plus B cap. What about magnitude of A cap plus B cap? Plus you will get. Here you will get plus. 1 plus cos theta is equal to 2 cos square theta by 2. That's why you will get this one as 2 times cos theta by 2. That is the another question. So next question is in this way. The scalar product of the vector I plus j plus k, it is I cap, j cap, k cap, with a unit vector along the sum of the vectors 2i plus 4j minus 5k and lambda I plus 2j plus 3k is 1. Once again, the scalar product of the vector, the scalar product of this vector with a unit vector along the sum of these two vectors. The scalar product of this vector along the unit vector. Sum of these two vectors, what happens? These two sum is equals to 2 plus lambda into I plus 6j minus 2k. That is the sum of these two vectors. Now, what is a unit vector in this direction? In this direction, unit vector means we have to divide with its magnitude. That's why divide with its magnitude, square root of 2 plus lambda whole square plus 36 plus 4. So this is the information. This vector we have to dot product with I plus j plus k. Their dot product is given as 1. the scalar product of this vector with a unit vector along the sum of these two vectors. These two sum, unit vector, this is dot product with I plus j plus k is given as 1. Then what is the value of lambda he is asking. So then what we can write, these two dot product you know how to find out, that is 2 plus lambda, next plus 6 minus 2 is equals to square root of 2 plus lambda whole square plus 40, right? Now squaring on both sides, what happens? This 6 minus 2 is equal to 4. Squaring on both sides, we will get 2 plus lambda whole square plus 4 square plus 2 into 2 plus lambda into 4 is equals to 2 plus lambda whole square plus 40. Here 2 plus lambda whole square, here 2 plus lambda whole square, cancel, you will get the value of lambda or not. So that is the discussion regarding that particular question. So let's have a discussion of another question here. The question is given in this way: A bar, B bar, C bar. These three vectors are mutually perpendicular vectors at the same time of equal magnitude given. Three vectors are mutually perpendicular vectors of equal magnitude given. And also he is asking that vector, that means A bar plus B bar plus C bar is equally inclined with A bar, B bar, C bar. That means angle between A bar plus B bar plus C bar and A bar, angle between A bar plus B bar plus C bar and B bar, angle between A bar plus B bar plus C bar and C bar is equal, we have to show. Okay, for that first of all, I am going to find out the magnitude of A bar plus B bar plus C bar. I want to find out because its magnitude is required. Why its magnitude is required? And one vector is A bar plus B bar plus C bar. The other vector is A bar. We want to find out the angle between these two. Formula is their dot product divided by magnitude of A bar plus B bar plus C bar into magnitude of A bar. That is the formula for finding angle between two vectors. Their dot product divided by their magnitudes multiplication. Right? But we know magnitude of A bar is equal to lambda. These two dot product also we can find out. This value we don't know. That's why I am finding that value. Its whole square is equal to mod A bar whole square plus mod B bar whole square plus mod C bar whole square plus 2 times A bar dot B bar plus B bar dot C bar plus C bar dot A bar. But in the question what he has given? In the question he has given that A bar, B bar, C bar are mutually perpendicular vectors. When they are mutually perpendicular vectors, A bar dot B bar is equal to 0, B bar dot C bar is equal to 0, C bar dot A bar is also equal to 0. So this value becomes 0. Here it is lambda square, lambda square, lambda square. So we are getting 3 times lambda square. Therefore, magnitude of A bar plus B bar plus C bar is equal to root 3 into lambda. So we got the information of magnitude of A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Now we can find out the angle between them. A bar dot A bar is equals to mod A bar whole square. Right? B bar dot A bar becomes 0. C bar dot A bar also becomes 0. They are mutually perpendicular. That's why B bar dot A bar 0. C bar dot A bar also 0. Divided by its value we got root 3 into lambda. Its value we got lambda. Now, what about this one? Lambda square cancel. We are getting 1 by root 3. Array angle between A bar plus B bar plus C bar and A bar we got cos theta is equal to 1 by root 3. That means theta is equal to cos inverse of 1 by root 3. Angle between A bar plus B bar plus C bar and A bar. Similarly, find out angle between this vector and B bar. Same you will get. Similarly, find out angle between this vector and C bar. You will get same. So that's why this vector is equally inclined with A bar, B bar, C bar, we can say. So another question is given. He is asking in the question, angle between the diagonals of a cube is cos inverse 1 by 3. Angle between the diagonals of a cube we have to find out. This is a cube. We have to find out the angle between the diagonals of a cube. you know, cube, all sides are equal. Let us say this one is y-axis and this one is z-axis and this is obviously x-axis. Let us say this is O, this is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, right? So this is origin 0, 0, 0. I am assuming the cube side is equal to small a. If the side of the cube is equal to small a means this length is equal to a. That's why this point obviously a 0, 0. Now this point is on y-axis. On y-axis, x coordinate 0, z coordinate 0. This point is on z-axis 0, 0, a. Next, observe. The point B is there in xy plane. When the point B is there in xy plane, in xy plane, z coordinate is equal to 0. That's why this particular point is a, 0. Now, this particular D is there in yz plane. In yz plane, x coordinate is equal to 0. Next, this point is there in xz plane. In xz plane, y coordinate is equal to 0. Therefore, you will get a, 0, a. Next, we have the point g is there in space. So, that's why that coordinates are a, only. First of all, you have to say, what are the diagonals of a cube here? Tell me two diagonals of a cube. Very clear. One diagonal is OZ. What about that vector OZ bar? OZ bar is equals to A into I cap because OG. Position vector of G minus position vector of O. So that's why A minus 0, A minus 0, A minus 0. AI plus AJ plus AK. That is the vector OZ bar. But what about the other diagonal? Right? OZ, we got one diagonal. Diagonal means from this corner to this corner. So the other diagonal we can take it as CF. Right? So CF bar is the other diagonal. So what about its direction, its vector? CF bar is equal to AI minus AJ plus AK. Now we got the two vectors. He is asking angle between two diagonals of a cube only. We got the two diagonals, so we can find out the angle between them. Angle between them is given by cos theta is equals to these two dot product a square minus a square plus a square divided by its magnitude is equals to root 3 into a. Its magnitude are a square plus a square plus a square under root. Root of 3 a square. So that's why it becomes a root 3 only. Here also you will get a root 3. So we are getting numerator as a square cancel. A square divided by 3 times a square cancel. We are getting 1 by 3. Therefore theta is equals to cos inverse 1 by 3 is the angle between the two diagonals of a cube. That is the way of finding the angle between two diagonals of a cube. So this is another question. Thus, this question I can say it as easy question. Magnitude of A bar is equal to 3 and magnitude of B bar is equals to 4. Magnitude of C bar is equals to 5 and each vector is perpendicular to the sum of other two. Each vector is perpendicular to sum of other two. That is the information given. And each vector is perpendicular to the sum of other two. That is the information given. Then he is asking to find magnitude of A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Right? So he is given this vector is perpendicular to sum of other two. That means A bar is perpendicular to B bar plus C bar. Then I can say these two dot product is equal to 0. These two dot product is equal to 0. These two dot product is equal to 0. But he is asking to find out magnitude of A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Now I am finding magnitude of A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Whole square I am finding. That is equals to magnitude of A bar whole square plus magnitude of B bar whole square plus magnitude of C bar whole square plus 2 times A bar dot B bar plus B bar dot C bar plus C bar dot A bar. Sir, I know this value is equal to 9, this value is equal to 16, this value is equal to 25, but what about this value? Add all these. A bar dot B bar plus A bar dot C bar, B bar dot C bar plus B bar dot A bar, C bar dot A bar plus C bar dot B bar. All these addition you will get this one only. So that's why this value is 0, and whereas this one is equal to 9 plus 16 plus 25, so we are getting 50. Right? Therefore, magnitude of A bar plus B bar plus C bar, we can say root 50, that is nothing but 5 root 2. Okay? So like that we can discuss a good number of questions based on the dot product. Let's have a discussion of one more question here. A bar, B bar, C bar are given as unit vectors. These three vectors are unit vectors given, that means their magnitude is equals to 1. At the same time he is asking what is the minimum value of magnitude of A bar plus B bar whole square plus B bar plus C bar whole square plus C bar plus A bar whole square. Next he is asking what is the maximum value of magnitude of A bar minus B bar whole square plus magnitude of B bar minus C bar whole square plus C bar minus A bar whole square. Right? So the first one is asking minimum value of this, and the second one is asking maximum value of this. Okay, first one I am saying, first one. That simplification you will get magnitude of A bar whole square plus magnitude of B bar whole square plus magnitude of C bar whole square. Two times you will get magnitude of A bar whole square plus magnitude of B bar whole square plus magnitude of C bar whole square. Two times you will get. That's why I can write simply that we can write it as two times summation of magnitude of A bar whole square. That value again is nothing but 2 times 3, that is equal to 6. Followed or not? Are A bar, magnitude of A bar whole square plus magnitude of B bar whole square plus 2 into A bar dot B bar. Next also, magnitude of B bar whole square, magnitude of C bar whole square plus 2 into B bar dot C bar. So like that, 6 plus 2 times summation A bar dot B bar. If any confusion with summation, I am writing A bar dot B bar plus B bar dot C bar plus C bar dot A bar. So this value is equal to this one. In the similar way, observe the second question also. This value you will get 6 minus 2 times A bar dot B bar plus B bar dot C bar plus C bar dot A bar. Because here plus is there, that's why you will get plus. Here minus is there, you will get minus. Okay, but what about these values? We don't know about these values, but we know magnitude of A bar plus B bar plus C bar is always greater than or equals to 0. Magnitude of A bar plus B bar plus C bar is always greater than or equal to 0. That's why I can write magnitude of A bar whole square, magnitude of B bar whole square plus magnitude of C bar whole square plus 2 times A bar dot B bar plus B bar dot C bar plus C bar dot A bar is greater than or equals to 0. That's why I can write A bar dot B bar plus B bar dot C bar plus C bar dot A bar is greater than or equal to minus 3 by 2. Or this minimum value we got minus 3 by 2. This minimum value we got minus 3 by 2. So in the first question what he is saying, this value we have to find out plus. Okay. So we have to find out this minimum value. To get this entire expression minimum value, here we have to give minimum. What is its minimum value? Minus 3 by 2. That's why 6 plus 2 times minus 3 by 2. So you will get the answer as 3. Next, we require its maximum value. Right? We required its maximum value. He is asking in the question maximum value of this. We required its maximum value. To get its maximum value, we are subtracting. Minimum we have to subtract. If minimum we are subtracting means this total value is becoming maximum or not. So minimum we have to subtract from this. That's why I can write 6 minus 2 times minus 3 by 2, that is equals to 9. So minimum value we got 3, its maximum value we got 9. So one more question here, it's a different types of questions. These are, so the question is given like this: a bar is equals to 5y minus 2j plus 5k. This vector we have to express, this vector we have to express as the sum of two vectors, such that one vector is parallel to 3i plus k, the other vector is perpendicular to this 3i plus k. What is asking in the question? Express this vector as the sum of two vectors. That means he is asking to express 5i minus 2j plus 5k. So that is a bar. We have to express this one as alpha bar plus beta bar. Express this vector as the sum of two vectors, such that one vector is parallel to this one, the other vector is perpendicular to this one. Right? So we have to find out alpha bar and beta bar. Okay. So express this vector as the sum of two vectors, such that one vector is parallel to this one, the other vector is perpendicular to this one. So what I am doing, observe here, alpha bar is parallel to b bar. These two vectors are parallel, means collinear. So we can write one can be expressed as the scalar multiple of other vector. Therefore we can write alpha bar is equals to lambda into 3i plus k. So now we got alpha bar. Okay, so alpha bar substitute here. Then what happens? 5i minus 2j plus 5k is equals to 3 lambda into I plus lambda k plus beta bar. Right? Shift to this side. Then what happens? 5 minus 3 lambda into I plus minus 2j. Next, plus 5 minus lambda into k is equals to beta bar. Okay, so that is beta bar. But what we know, beta bar is perpendicular to this one. Alpha bar is parallel to this one. Beta bar is perpendicular to this one. Perpendicular means what? Dot product is equal to 0. That's why beta bar dot product with b bar. Beta bar dot b bar is equals to 0. So that's why 5 minus 3 lambda into I minus 2j plus 5 minus lambda into k, that is beta bar dot 3i plus k is equals to 0. So this root dot product equal to 0, we will get lambda value or not? Once we got the value of lambda, means we got beta bar, we got alpha bar. Lambda value we got means we got alpha bar and we got beta bar also. So alpha bar, beta bar, substitute here. Alpha bar we got, beta bar we got, substitute here. Please don't add. If you are adding means what happens? You will get this one only. He is asking express. Express as the sum of two vectors and then leave. So that's why alpha bar and beta bar substitute here after getting the value of lambda from here. So this is one more beautiful question based on Cauchy's squash inequality. Let's see, the question is given like this: x comma y comma z are real numbers such that the information is given as 3x minus 4y plus 5z is equals to 10. Then he is asking the minimum value of x square plus y square plus z square. Right? So that is the question. He is asking x, y, z are real numbers such that 3x minus 4y plus 5z is equals to 10. Then the minimum value of x square plus y square plus z square we have to find out. Now what I am doing is I am taking a bar is equals to xi plus yj plus zk. B bar is equals to 3i minus 4j plus 5k. 3i minus 4j plus 5k. As we know, a bar dot b bar whole square is always less than or equals to mod a bar whole square into mod b bar whole square. This is a Cauchy-Schwarz inequality. Now, a bar dot b bar is nothing but 3x minus 4y plus 5z whole square is less than or equals to mod a bar whole square. Array, mod a bar whole square means x square plus y square plus z square into mod b bar whole square. This vector magnitude whole square. Now what happens this one? That is nothing but 50, right? Because its vector magnitude is root over 50. Okay, root over 50 whole square will get 50. Now this is equals to this value given in the question as a 10. Okay, so this is 10 means 10 square is 100. So 100 greater than or equals to x square plus y square plus z square divided by 50. That's why x square plus y square plus z square minimum value is equals to 2, because x square plus y square plus z square is always greater than or equals to 2. That is the base question based on Cauchy-Schwarz inequality. So try to practice more questions. Next class we are going to discuss about vector product. Okay, bye.